Hello, welcome to online classes, children. Today in our chapter number 1, large numbers, we are going to study about Roman numerals. Can you see this picture, children? You see, this is a picture of one of the house, and only a small part I have taken here to show you. You can see some letters are written over here, okay? And these letters are actually it is a numeral, okay? This is a Roman numeral. The next picture, if I show you, you can see here a clock, and the numbers are written in the Roman numerals. Okay, so this is second example, and third one, if I show you, you can see this dice and the symbol of Super Bowl. Okay, these all things are in Roman numerals. So children, we find that today also we use Roman numerals. Okay, and so what is actually Roman numerals? See, Roman numerals, it is based on the letters of English alphabets which are combined to signify their values. Okay, so the numbers, okay, the Roman numerals are written by the alphabets of English, and when we combine them, they form the Roman numerals. Alright, so Roman numerals is one of the early system of writing numerals. This system originated in ancient Rome, and Romans did not have zero in their number system and were not aware of the place value system either. They used only seven basic symbols for writing numerals, and these are the seven basic numbers, children. These are the seven basic symbols which are used. Okay, you can see here I stands for 1, V equals to 5, X equals to 10, L equals to 50, C equals to 100, D equals to 500, and M equals to 1000. Okay, so you can see one more picture. If I show you, all the alphabets are written over here, and this numbers are written. If I show you this picture, children, you can see one mnemonics I have shown here, and all the capital letters you can see M, D, C, L, X, V, I. Okay, so starting from the lower number, that is starting from the lower side I. So you can see I stands for 1 and moving towards the ascending order. So that is V stands for 5, X equals to 50, X equals to 10, L equals to 50, C equals to 100, D equals to 500, and M equals to 1000. So this is all about your Roman numerals. Now children, we have to follow some rules for writing the numbers, for combining the alphabets. We have to follow some rules to form the Roman numerals. The first rule says, if a symbol is repeated, its value is added as many times as it occurs. So that means whenever the symbol is repeated, we add its value. The second rule says, if a smaller numeral follows a large numeral, the numbers are added. Okay, that means if a smaller numeral is coming afterwards, and then before that any big numeral is there, okay, that means large numeral is there and then the smaller numeral is there, so we add both the values. The third rule says, if a smaller numeral precedes a large numeral, the numbers are subtracted. Okay, precedes means smaller numeral is coming before, and then coming and then comes the large numeral, then we subtract the smaller one from the large numeral. Next rule says, a symbol is not repeated more than 3 times, but the symbols V, L, and D are never repeated or subtracted. Okay, that means any symbol when we repeat, only 3 times maximum we can repeat it. Okay, but V stands for, V is equal to 5, L equals to 50, and D equals to 500. So we don't repeat these 3 alphabets, and we don't subtract these alphabets from any other alphabet. Okay, the next new rule says, when a smaller numeral is written in between 2 large numerals, it is always subtracted from the large numeral just after it. Okay, that means when 2 numerals are given two large numerals are given and in between the smaller numeral is written. So we always subtract the smaller one from the large numeral which is coming just after it. So children, we will be discussing this all rules one by one with examples. So let us see the first rule. As I told, if a symbol is repeated, its value is added as many times as it occurs. Okay, I have shown these all symbols over here so that it will be easy for you all to recognize and learn. Okay, so let us take I and I. Okay, two times I have written over here. That means the I is repeating. Okay, so we will add both the numerals. Okay, so I equals to 1, then plus, then again I is there, so we will add 1 more. Okay, so that means I plus I, that is 1 plus 1 equals to 2. All right, the second example, if I take x, you can see here we are repeating x maximum 3 times. Okay, so what is the value of x? The value of x is 10, so we can so we have to add here according to the rule. So 3 times x is there, so we are writing 10 plus 10 plus 10, that is equal to 30. Next question, m. Okay, so the value of m is 1000, so we have written 3 times m here, so that is why we are adding 1000 plus 1000 plus 1000, that is equal to 3000. The next now question is c. Okay, here only c is only written twice, so we will add c and c. So what is the value of c? That is 100. So 100 plus 100, that's equal to 200. The second rule says if a smaller numeral follows the large numeral, the new numbers are added. Okay, that means you can see over here the smaller one is coming after the large one. Okay, so V stands for 5 and I stands for 1. So if the smaller one is coming after the large one, then we have to add both the values. That is why we have added here 5 plus 1, that is equal to 6. Next question, xi. Okay, the value of x is 10 and the value of I is 1. So smaller one is coming after the bigger one, that is why we are adding both the values. That is 10 plus 1, that is equal to 11. So this is your second rule, children. One more example, if we take L and X. So the value of L is 50 and the value of X is 10. So again the smaller one is coming after the bigger one, so that is why we have added here. So 50 plus 10 is equal to 60. Next rule says if a smaller numeral precedes a large numeral, the numbers are subtracted. That means you can see here with the example, if I explain, the smaller one is coming first and then the bigger one is coming afterwards. Okay, the smaller one is preceding the bigger one. That means smaller one is coming before the bigger value. Okay, then we have to subtract the smaller one from the bigger one. As you can see, this I and V, so the value of I is 1 and value of V is 5, so that is why we have subtracted 1 from 5. So 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. So we'll take another example. Let's see IX. Okay, so the value of I is 1 and the value of X is 10. So you can see here the smaller one is coming before the bigger one. Okay, that is why we have to subtract the smaller one from the bigger one. So you can see 10 minus 1, that is equal to 9. One more example, XL. So the value of X is 10, the value of L is 50. So 50 minus 10, that is equal to 40. As you can see, the smaller one is coming first and then comes the large one. So we will subtract the smaller one from the bigger one. Okay, so this was your third rule. The next rule says, children, a symbol is not repeated more than 3 times, but the symbols V, L and D are never repeated or subtracted. Okay, so this means if any symbol we want to write, for example, you take 30. So 30 we can write X and X, 3 times X, that is maximum number we can repeat is 3 times. So we have repeated X 3 times, that is equal to 30. Okay, and one more example, if I take, suppose if I want to write 40, so 40 cannot be repeated 40 cannot be written as x x x x 4 times x, because we cannot write any number 4 times, any letter 4 times. So that is why we have written xl. So previous rule is followed here, that is smaller one is coming first and then comes the bigger one. So we have to subtract the smaller one from the bigger one. So the value of L is 50 and the value of X is 10. So that is why 50 minus 10, that is equal to 40. So we have written in this manner. Okay. Now you can see here, children, but the symbols V, L and D are never repeated or subtracted. That means you can see V is equals to 5. L equals to 50 and D is equal to 500. So these three alphabets are never repeated. That means we can write this only once. Okay. And next thing is that we can never subtract these numbers, or we can never subtract these alphabets from the other alphabets. All right. That means we cannot write DM. Okay. Because D is never subtracted. Okay. So that is why in this way we don't have to repeat V, L and D. Okay. And these three alphabets are never subtracted. The next rule says, when a smaller numeral is written in between the two large numerals, it is always subtracted from the large numeral just after it. Okay. For example, if I take XIX, that means 2x, that means 10, and this, the value of x is 10. So in between I is written, that is 1. Okay. So in between the two large number, a smaller numeral is written. That is why we have to subtract the smaller one from the bigger one, which is coming just after it. That means we have to subtract I from this side x, right side x, which is coming just after it. Okay. So this x is written as 10 over here, then plus sign, and then ix. So we have to subtract I from x, that is 10 minus 1. Okay, so again this 10 we have taken it as it is over here, plus sign we have taken down. So 10 minus 1 is 9, and here 10 plus 9 is 19. If another example I take, it is liv, so 50. So again, two bigger values are here, and in between the smaller one is there. So L is, the value of L is 50 and IV. So we'll subtract I from V. Okay, that is 5 minus 1, that is 4. So 50 plus 4 is 54. Now children, the next rule says, I can be subtracted from V and X only. Okay, that means we can write IV as it is saying I can be subtracted from V, that is 5 minus 1, that is 4. Okay. And I can be subtracted from X, that is 10 minus 1 equals to 9. Okay. So I can be subtracted from V, that is from 5, and I can be subtracted from X, that is from 10. Okay. Next rule says that X can be subtracted from L and C only. That means, for example, if I take XL, okay, so X we are subtracting from L. So and the value of L is 50, 50 minus 10 is 40, okay. So 10 can be subtracted from 50 only, okay. So X can be subtracted from L only. So that is why we have written XL, all right. And then again, X can be subtracted from C only, okay. So X, the value of X is 10 and the value of C is 100. Okay. So we are subtracting 100 minus 10. So that is equal to 90. So we have written like X can be subtracted from L and C only. So we have written both the things over here, XL and XC. The next rule says C can be subtracted from D and M only. Okay. As you see here, C, D I have written. So 500 minus 100. So as the value of D is 500, we are subtracting 100 from 500, that is 400. And another one is CM. So value of C is 100, value of M is 1000. So we are subtracting 100 from 1000, we will get 900. So children, these are the rules. Please go through it and learn it by heart it. And this will be helpful for you all to solve the questions. So please go through each and every rule and learn it. Thank you.